our most valued student. My name is Confident. Welcome to our revision session. And I chose to look at fractions, and it is mainly suitable for those who are doing their mathematics N2. And also if you are doing your grade 9, your grade 10, your grade 11, even grade 12, this is just basic algebra that you need to know. So if you are doing your N1, N2, N3, this is just suitable for anyone who's studying towards their maths. Now, I mean towards their exams in mathematics, pure maths. Now let us look at this question. It says simplify the following and you need to show all steps. So how do you go about this one? First things first, you need to identify a few key things here. Now the first part you need to identify is that denominator. You can see that it can be simplified further, and somehow you will see that it is related to these denominators. Now do not be tempted to make this to say the common denominator is x plus 4 and it's x minus 4, and then you're saying it's x squared minus 16. Do not be tempted to say that. Why am I saying it? I just want to show you a few things here to say. If you simplify further, x squared, in this case, x squared minus 16, you'll see that this is same as x squared. Now 16 is 4 squared, and this is a difference of 2 squares, where you've got x minus 4 as well as x plus 4. If you still remember, this is a difference of 2 squares. Now you can see that x plus 4 is there, and x minus 4 is also there. So hence I'm saying the common denominator in this case is not this one. So when you write it down, you say equal to, in this case you've got x over x plus 4 plus x over x minus 4 minus 8x over, and then you've got your x minus 4 and your x plus 4. So that is where they wanted you to give you a mark there. Such questions are around 5 marks, and you need to be able to then get your first mark in the stage. And then when you continue, the common denominator therefore is x plus 4 and x minus 4. This is the common denominator in this case. Let me just use something much straight. So how do you simplify that? So what we are saying is, we are saying x plus 4 into x plus 4, x minus 4. You can see that it will cancel that, and what is going to remain is x minus 4. Then you are going to take x minus 4 and you will multiply with the top. So let me do it now. So let me repeat again. I said you are going to say x minus 4 into our common denominator, and x plus 4 and x plus 4 will cancel. So if I can do it on the other side, we are saying x plus 4 and x minus 4 divided by the first one, which is x plus 4. So what we're saying is, you see, that will cancel, remaining with that. So this is what you take as your x minus 4 in this case. Remember, that's what remained, but you have to multiply by that top, which is, you put your x, it's better to put it before like that. Then you go to the plus here, and then it's plus, you do the same thing now, divided by its x minus 4, which is this one here. So it will be x minus 4, and you see the x minus 4 will cancel the x minus 4 to remain with the x plus 4 in this case. So you'll have now the x plus 4, but multiplied by the top, which is that particular x. Then you've got minus, The next one is x minus 4 and is x plus 4. You can see that this whole thing cancelled to that whole thing, and then what you are left with is minus, so it's a 1 that you are left with, so it's 1 times 8x in this case. So that's what you are having. So if you simplify this thing, you can bring of course your 8x near, but this is fine. Then when you want to simplify, we have to open the bracket, and when you're opening the bracket, x times x and x minus times minus 4, x times x and x times 4 minus 18x. So we'll be having x times x is x squared, x times 4 minus 4x, plus x times x, which is x squared, x times 4, now is positive 4x. Now 1 times 8x is minus 8x. And then you still maintain your denominator, which is your x plus 4 and your x minus 4. Then you have to collect your like terms, and so that you can simplify. So you have got your x squared, as you can see, I have that and I have that, I'm bringing it together. So which is my x squared plus, in this case, x squared. And again, I have minus 4x plus 4x minus 8 as common there. So I will bring it together as minus 4x plus 4x minus 8x. You still maintain your common denominator, which is our x plus 4 and our x minus 4. Now when you simplify further, what we have now, 4 minus 4x plus 4x, this can actually cancel out because it's 0. So what we'll be having is equal to x squared minus 8x. As you can see, actually x plus x, it's 2x squared. Sorry about that, because there is a 1 there. 1 plus 1 is 2. So it's 2x squared over x plus 4, and I have got x minus 4. Therefore, you continue. Something interesting, what is common when you factorize the top, you see you have got 2x squared minus 8x. So you look at the number 2 and 8, 2 is common, and then x squared and x is x that you need to take out. So it's 2x. Now 2x into 2x squared, as I said, it's more like you are dividing. So what you have is 2x squared over 2x. The 2 cancels, the x cancels, only 1 is remaining. So you'll be having, in this case, x minus, again you do the same thing now, it is 8x over 2x. The x will cancel now, 2 into 8 is a 4. So it's x minus 4 in that case over x plus 4, and again it's x minus 4. And then when you simplify it further, you can still cancel out the x minus 4 and x minus 4, and our answer in this case is 2x over x plus 4. Then this becomes the simplified expression of that particular fraction. Now we can quickly test our answer here to say, if we want to test, we can say let x be equal to, choose any value, let's say 9. So wherever there is x, you put a 9, you put a 9, so that you can see what it simplified to. So if I can take a calculator there and say, in this case, 2 times 9 over 9 plus 4. Then my answer is 18 over 13. So remember that answer, which is here I'm getting 18 over 13 when x is equal to 9. Shall I can write it here to say I got 18 over 13. Remember that answer. I do the same thing. In the original, I also say let x be equal to 9. So I'll have my 9, my 9, my 9, my 9, and my 9. It must give me 18 over 13. If it simplifies and give me that, it means my simplification is correct. So I've got 4 over 9 plus 4 plus 9 over 9 minus 4 minus, and then I've got fraction, which is 8 times 9 over 9 squared minus 16. Remember, I must get 18 over 13. So I'm saying that I'm getting a different answer here. Let me check again. I said my x is 9, 4 over 9 plus 4 plus my x is 9 over 9 minus 4 minus 8 times 9 over 9 squared minus 16. I'm getting an answer of 1, but I think I already see where the error is. And the error is, I made an error. Just look at this part. This was 4. I hope you picked it up already, but I ended up calling it x. So I need to correct that, because wherever there is x, it's supposed to be a 4 in this case. And if I continue with that, this is the same x here. And this particular x was supposed to be a 4. And if I continue with that, I was then supposed to change this part. The first two here, I need to change it because I'm multiplying by 4. So it will become 4 times x. It is 4x. 4 times minus 4, which is minus 16. That was what it was supposed to be. And then after that, my collection of like terms also must change. Now everything must change from here. Actually, I can only change the top because the denominator doesn't change. So everything here has to change, and also everything here has to change, and here I can actually change like that. So if I simplify this further, what I have it is, if I collect my like terms, as you can see, it's x squared that I have there, nothing common to it. And then looking at x, I have got 4x, I've got 4x, I've got minus 8x. If I bring it together, it will be plus 4x plus 4x minus 8x. And then lastly, I've got minus 16 there, which is minus 16. Now, if you say, in this case, 4x plus 4x minus 8x, you see 4x plus 4x is 8x, and 8x minus 8x will cancel out. So in a way, you can literally say that this, this, and that, they cancel out. So what you have got x squared minus 16 on top. Now remember, x squared minus 16 is actually x squared minus 4 squared over x plus 4 and x minus 4, which is equal to difference of 2 squares again on top, x plus 4, x minus 4 over x plus 4 and x minus 4. And then when you say cancel out x plus 4, x plus 4, x minus 4, x minus 4. Hence the answer that you get from here, it will be equal to a 1. That's why question that, if you remember, it gave us an answer of x was equal to 1, and you don't need to test at this stage. Whatever I get on top here, remember I got a 1. So which means whatever value of x that you put, I got a 1, then the value for 1 is the actual answer. Now you can see what is the importance I usually emphasize on testing my answers. It's because I usually make a lot of errors sometimes, and just sometimes writing the wrong thing is plain. I can see the 4, but I don't know why I end up writing an x. But when I go back to test my answers, it actually helps me to correct some errors that I would have made along. So it is also very important if you can also use such strategies, because most students usually struggle with the same scenario or situation that I usually have, whereby the more tired sometimes you become, the more errors you start making. So if you keep on testing your answers like this, you have an assurance that you pick up any error that you have made along. And again guys, remember such things you can only keep benefiting if you subscribe to our channel and turn on that notification bell so that you can be notified whenever there are videos. We have come to the end of our lesson. Thank you.